Hi, I'm Spencer. Are you being attacked right now? You aren't? Good. Are you about to be attacked? See, if your answer was no, you're wrong, because you never know when you're about to be attacked, which is why today, I'm going to teach you how to defend yourself. The first step in self-defense is to disable the attacker and take away their weapon. If they have a knife, you grab the blade of the knife and then you start to punch the shit out of them, because they can't stab you if there's no blade. If they have a gun, then you run around the attacker and use their body as a shield from their bullets. And if they have a blunt object, then you call the cops because pot's illegal. Now that your attacker is nice and disabled, you're going to want to hit him. But where should you hit him? When attacking an attacker, you're going to want to hit one of three vulnerable spots: his groin, his eyes, or his nipples. If you hit any of these sensitive spots, you're bound to have an effective strike.
Ow, my groin. Ow, my eyes. Ooh, my nipples.
Well, congratulations. Looks like you successfully defended a- Oh no! The attacker has you from behind. What do you do now? In this scenario, it's best to step on the foot of the attacker, rendering his feet useless. Or, you throw that ass back into him, sending that son of a bitch into orbit. Then, you quickly run in a zigzag pattern to discombobulate your attacker, and then congratulations, you successfully defended yourself against an attacker.
Now, you know how to successfully defend yourself. And you might be thinking that you're invincible and you can conquer the world. But don't do that, because there's a lot of attackers that we don't know how to defend ourselves against yet. Like addiction. If I could escape, I would, but first of all, let me say, I must apologize for acting, stinking, treating you this way. Cause I've been acting like sour milk, fell on the floor, it's your fault, you didn't shut the refrigerator, maybe